Right, hi guys. Quick thing. We get a lot of, I think online gaming and the whole internet of everything gets a bad rep out there.
That's what I don't agree with you. Okay, I'm a bit older and the online gaming thing to me is negative. I'm not really happy with my kids spending time gaming online without me babysitting them.
Both of us have got two kids, and I think we see different sides of it. I online game. I spend hours online. I've got a whole community, a clan where we got organized gaming sessions. We've got competitive gaming sessions, and my kids are growing up in a house where they actually starting to we play together, and there's this whole teamwork, camaraderie thing, and you're meeting new people outside of the whole world, and making lifelong friends you've never met before, but you're on Facebook together and you're on WhatsApp groups together, and it's a whole little world niche in itself. And I see with my youngsters that we as parents who online game together, we're actually getting the kids to start playing together, so our kids know each other, and they've got We've got missions, and I'm building something, and the kids are shooting, or I don't build that well. So like in Fortnite, my son's building the walls, and I'm getting on the wall, and I'm shooting. So he's actually saving my bacon, and he's only 9 years old. So for me, the hand-eye coordination, the social skills, the taking lead, making decisions. Yes, Dad, we're going left, we're going right, or don't go there. I've seen people that side. Or,
no, makes sense.
There's
social skills are important.
Social skills are important, and everything in balance. I mean, the kids they do their sports and they outdoorsy and they do their homework. But there's solid times where we can actually bond as a family, and I see the self confidence that grows out of that kid winning a match, and his dad was there, and we were even in a team. How many dads and sons are actually in a team together?
Okay, now you know my story. I'm gonna just quickly tell my story. And what to do, advice them, how I should handle this. I installed Minecraft on my kid's iPad. All of a sudden, I see them typing, and I thought, why are you typing? You should be playing the game. And I noticed they were chatting to somebody online, and the guy was asking, assuming it's a guy, weird questions like, what's your name? How old are you? Where do you stay? What's your Wi-Fi password? I don't know what he wanted to do that. And I was so afraid, I actually lost it a bit, that some weirdo on the other side of this Minecraft chat that's, you know, getting inside my kids' heads. And maybe I'm not prepared. How would you handle that?
For me, online gaming and stuff like that is it's family time for us.
So you're there the whole time?
I'm there the whole time. There's software, you've installed NetNanny, yeah. Which helps. What I do is certain games, with the kids, I've told them that they are not allowed, so that's a rule now, so they're not allowed to have mics on and they should mute everybody else in the chat board when they're playing. And there's a level of trust that I trust them that they do that. I've done random checks, they do.
But obviously you have had them to speak to them.
They do understand. Listen, there are bad people out there, and it's like with everything. Anything and everything in the world can be negative.
I must say I'm impressed with kids' control, and they sometimes they kick your back.
Yeah, I'm at that stage where I need some practice.
Mm. Okay, so the tear down the bottom line is get some good software installed. Maybe have a DNS server that blocks the bad sites, and monitor. Yeah.